This week's Ask Dr. Durie is again a rather common question. It comes from a patient with smoldering myeloma who wants to know, should they start treatment? And what that means is they want to know if they have what's called high-risk smoldering myeloma, where the risk of turning into active myeloma is high within the next year, year and a half or so. And the problem arises because that high-risk definition is based upon three test results right now. The level of the myeloma protein in the blood, if it's 2 grams or higher, the percentage of myeloma cells in the bone marrow, if it's 20% or higher, and the free light ratio, if it's 20 or higher. And the problem, for example, for this patient is that the numbers have been fluctuating around these different levels. And so it's been hard to know. Maybe one test result, the results are above the 220/20, and next time they're not. And so my strong recommendation in this situation is to wait and to continue to monitor. If these numbers are fluctuating, this is not a good situation to be decisively moving forward with therapy. It's better to wait, recheck, and see if the numbers are going up month upon month or every 3 months, possibly, if things are changing very slowly. So the first recommendation is definitely to wait. The second point is that of the various tests that we have, the percentage of plasma cells in the bone marrow is perhaps the most indicative of a higher risk of progression. If the percentage of plasma cells in the bone marrow is increasing from 20% to 30% up to 40%, this is something to really pay attention to in terms of risk. This is often reflected by a change in the whole body PET CT scan. In other words, if the percentage of plasma cells is going up, then this is often reflected by maybe a new lesion showing up on an MRI or a PET CT scan. And so these are significant tests, and so periodically at a 3 to 6 month interval, it would be reasonable to consider checking those kinds of things. But bottom line here is please hold off on treatment until there's a clear indication that you have crossed that threshold and there is a need for active treatment, because sometimes there can be fluctuations that continue for many months to years without the need for active intervention. So wait and be sure and monitor closely.